deny today in both cases, although I have penned a relatively lengthy concurrence in both cases that I believe speak for themselves, and I'd appreciate everyone reading. Thank you.
Thank you. Additional comments, Commissioner Trumbull?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I too will be voting in favor of these cases and have also written a concurring opinion, not quite as lengthy as Commissioner Hawks, but I hope you'll read it on the same. Thanks.
Thank you. And any additional comments, Commissioner Slaby?
Chairman, thank you. Let me start by saying that I fully support the order that we are issuing today, but I want to add my special thanks to all of the staff who have worked so diligently on this very, very difficult process that we've endeavored to undertake. I want to emphasize today that my belief in the free open markets and competition is not compromised with this order. First, we should look at the market to provide competition, innovation, and solutions for retail electric service without intervention. There are times, however, when outside factors may dictate some intervention into a perfect world. This is especially true when an immediate response is necessary for protection of the public health and safety. There are times we at the Public Utilities Commission make difficult decisions to assure consumers of adequate, safe, and reliable utility services at a fair price. In order to accomplish this mission, we must also ensure financial integrity and service reliability in the Ohio utility industry, both today and into the future. Without that financial integrity, the risk of failure of safety and reliability become a major concern. We must also continue to be sensitive to the economic impact of our decisions will have on consumers, local communities, as well as the state of Ohio. If I had a crystal ball, this job certainly would be much easier. Without generation, this can be called, it can be called upon immediately. We would not have a basic reliable utility grid. Yes, extended storage, lower cost of renewables, more energy efficiencies, even new sources of fuel are coming, but they are not here yet. Competition within emerging industries continues to incentivize new entities coming into the market. One or more of them may become the major electric producers of the future. And then, until that time arrives, we must rely on a complete portfolio of generation. This includes wind, solar, water, biomass, nuclear, coal, and gas-fired generation. Change will come. This order visualizes a gradual, smooth evolution into the industry rather than an abrupt change. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you. And Mr. Johnson.
Mr. Chairman, members of the Commission, I strongly support these orders. I'd like to thank the attorney examiners, staff, and my fellow commissioners for all their hard work. I'd also like to recognize the members of the public that provided comments regarding these cases, like Ohio's businesses, trade associations, labor unions, local governments, community organizations, and residential customers. Throughout this proceeding, I have received and docketed over 18,000 emails. I'm encouraged by the public's desire to be part of this complex process. I'd like to highlight that these orders adopt stipulations signed by not only the companies and the commissioner's staff, but also a diverse group of parties representing a multitude of interests. With the Commission's modifications, the result is two well-rounded compromises that balance the interests of all parties involved. These orders advance the Commission's mission statement to provide adequate, safe, and cost-effective services while facilitating a competitive environment. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Commissioners. And we have two cases on. All those in favor of approving each case is called. Please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
I vote aye as well. Any opposed? Those cases are approved as prepared. Case number 15.